In this video, we'll continue where we left last time with this topic. What exactly makes Assetto Corsa a better driving experience than project cars? The first thing we'll talk about this time is suspension behavior. The weight transfer is one of the best things about Assetto Corsa. How much each wheel is loaded at any time makes a huge difference to the car balance, and the way they load as you make inputs always makes sense. The same car can respond in a completely different way depending on how far you build up a steering lock or how far you release your brakes on that particular corner, that particular lap. As long as all four wheels are on the ground, project cars isn't all that different. The car is a bit less sensitive to changes in load in each of the four corners, and as a result, the way you move weight around with your inputs makes less of a difference. However, once we get to curb riding and airtime, the gap between both games becomes massive. Let's go deep here. One of the strange things about project cars is how much aggression it allows over curbs most of the time. If you drive a road car or a GT car, only the white lines can stop you from driving wherever you feel like. Curbs that are tricking the real tracks become a non-issue in this game. Look at what this Audi R8 can do in NGK chicane. Now, let's do a straight comparison with the same car in the same section. We'll pick the Pagani Sonda R at Barcelona last corners. First, we'll do it in Assetto Corsa, then in project cars. This is a car somewhere in the middle of the ladder between a road car and a single-seater, so we are going to see what happens if we attack hard this low chicane at the end of the circuit. You can see that the car doesn't explode or anything, but it doesn't enjoy riding these things. It catches air, you lose your line, and until it stops bouncing, you can't do much with it. This is by no means the fastest way through here. Now, same section in project cars. Let's see the difference. The car doesn't mind at all tackling these things dead in the center. It doesn't get unsettled at all. Laser scan tracks and correct shade for the curves contribute to this difference, but on top of that, there's something else working better on Assetto Corsa in the suspension side. Both games are also very different when cars go over a crest. This is how a car catches air in Assetto Corsa. If we see the replay now, there isn't anything funny about it. It makes sense, and you can't see anything sketchy happening mid there. Now, we will go through the same section in the same car in project cars. This time, we will see some force pushing the car to the ground. It changes momentum mid there. I'll tell you when it happens. Now, at a given point, it starts dropping much faster than it should, and you can also see the suspension starting to compress way before the car lands. If we go to an even bigger jump, we can see some more weird things happening. You probably know this jump if you play project cars. First, have a look at all that smoke. We are still far from landing, and the game behaves as if the tires were down. The tires are already biting. Also, the suspension is already compressed. Have a look at the landing of the rear end. It's completely unnatural. The front will barely bounce either after dropping from very high. All these jumps are rare scenarios and not very important, but these strange traits are still there when you simply ride a curb. You will still get to see smoke from the tires mid-air, and the car will have strange changes of momentum after taking off. If you have been watching for a while, you already know how much importance I give to this. The amount of grip in surfaces like AstroTurf, grass and gravel is going to change a lot the ideal racing line around the virtual racetracks. Assetto Corsa has a huge advantage here. In project cars, all this stuff is way, way too grippy, and it becomes an extension of the racetrack. Even in old school racetracks, where there's grass beyond the curves instead of a mile of runoff area, this game allows way too much nonsense behind the wheel. Imola is a good example of this, as most corners are still not completely sanitized. So we are going to take the Formula Renault around this track to see what I mean. It's worth saying that this car is probably the most sensitive to curves, grass and rough terrain in the whole game. It is super stiff, and it does not handle well being bounced, at least for project cars standards. So this is as realistic as this game is going to get in this era. Let's go on board now. I leave the telemetry view on so you can see how hard I am on the throttle out there. So now, what we will do is to pick a similar car around the same racetrack in Assetto Corsa. The situation will change big time. The grip is much lower, and you are forced to make choices. The turf will not kill you if you step on it, but you will have to watch what you are doing behind the wheel. In the end, you have to decide between staying on the black stuff and enjoying the full performance of your car, or taking extra width, extend your lines, and being more careful on the power and the steering. It's nice because going wide doesn't automatically spin you. You just get less grip, and as a result, you have to work out in which corners you can dip a wheel out to your advantage. If you're already traveling fast, it might pay off to extend the track a bit. Meanwhile, in the exit of a slow corner, you will want to stay on the tarmac if you want to get any sort of traction. If you try to extend the racetrack and don't compensate for it with extra caution, this will happen. But the grip levels aren't the only difference. Assetto Corsa understands that the grass around the racetrack is not the green of a golf course. In project cars, grass is like a pool table. You can enter and leave it at will completely under control. Now, on the other hand, let's see how cars react to grass in Assetto Corsa. The car bounces, dips down, and it is really hard to bring it back on the racetrack and keep it under control. Now, let's go through the same section in project cars. You can see that the grass does nothing at all. The car only bounces a bit to get over the curb. You always stay in control really easily. As you can see, it's a clear advantage for Assetto Corsa, and if you add more attention to detailing the tracks to already better physics, the gap gets bigger. Look at the strip of turf polishing the outside of turn 3 here, you really want to avoid it. Meanwhile, on project cars it's nowhere to be seen, so turn 3 becomes free for all sorts of abuse. And that's all, I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, thanks for watching.